Welcome, folks. Bill Speck, Opsmaker here. This is going to be your sit rep for Friday afternoon, 1 p.m. Central Time, coming to you from the great state of Texas. And it is going to be December 10th, 2021. Now, make sure you hit that like, subscribe, and bell for notification. And if you want to catch these live and you're on YouTube and you see this, you can actually do so by joining Patreon. It's about $3 a month entry level, and you catch all of the sit reps live as well as engage with the chats and lots of other stuff out there. So there is that. Now, without further ado, let's hop on over to our board. And so you guys can see, kicking it off in sky glass this morning, we're sitting, this one's showing about 287 up right now. Keeping in mind, the pinks are masked aircraft. Those are aircraft that do not want to be seen. So we do have a pretty good amount of those in the sky. If we kick into kind of the numbers in general, we do have an emergency aircraft up here in the northeast. The red one there says no radio. That's what that NR, that squawk, NR, or N-O-R-D-O, means no radio. Okay. All right. Trainers are, as always, you know, one of our heaviest up, sitting about 55 of those up. But heavy movers is pretty wild. We're sitting about 40 heavy movers up. And when I say that, I'm talking about the C-130s, C-17s in total. Let me just kind of clean our screen out here so you can see just nothing but that. And try that one more time. But yeah, this is pretty heavy for a Friday. Now, we do see more up on Fridays than we do any other time of the year, any time of the week, typically, of the heavy movers. This is kind of a big moving day for them. We usually don't see 40 of them up, so you can see they're pretty much coast to coast. Even have a couple out here in the Puerto Rico kind of area. But those are the heavy lifters. Now, if we go look at, let me back these up. I'm going to show you what was going on this morning as well. Just looking at the air refuelers, 18 tankers in terms of KC-135s. And let me find the others. We do have a handful of others. One DC-10 that is up. Let me just make sure as I'm kind of scanning through these. Not seeing that. Okay, that's okay though. So I'm going to clear what we got. Let me back this up so we can see everything that's up and out. Skinny this little dude down. And then let me show you what was going on this morning over Florida, which was kind of a crazy thing. We started out, let me just show you the Florida piece. Very active this morning. Now, this is actually over on OpenADSB Exchange, just kind of a flat map so you can see what was going on there. But we had some heavy lifts. We had a lot of air refuelers up over Florida, which would indicate a lot of fighters. Looked like they were doing that little touch-and-go pattern there over the center of the state. But Teal 86, now that's a weather, and Teal 85, those are weather C-130s. Looked like those were just moving through across the state. And then this one here, this Quad-X, I don't know what that deal was, but again, fighter. There was one fighter there, and then we had a P-8 that was down there. Now, I'll show you the P-8s that were up too, and then there's one of our fighters out just running some routes off of the coast at altitude. So, and then, of course, we had some air refuelers that were up over that southeast kind of Jacksonville area also. So, it's like I said this morning, for Florida, I normally don't see that much. Now, this is going to be your tanker air refueler. See him up there running, doing some circling around 21,000 feet. That is what you would get when you have a lot of fighters out over that general area. Typically, you put some fuelers up so that those guys don't have to land. So that was Florida this morning. Now let's just take a look at the rest of the U.S. this morning. When I say this morning, I'm talking, you know, 11 a.m. This is only an hour and a half, 2 hours ago. But if you look at the tankers that were just popping up, we kind of went hot there for a little while. This is the amount of tankers that were just over kind of the southeast and up the northeast side, you know, the right side of the U.S. That is a lot of tankers, folks. So when you have that many tankers, you typically have exponentially larger amount of fighters. You can't see the fighters. That's not uncommon. Fighters just they don't want to be seen. They don't really broadcast their position. They squawk at different things and use different transponders. So you're not going to see those. But these were the air refuelers that were up early over the Northeast, which was, you know, you got Delaware and Jersey and that general area. Now, again, this has been kind of regular. Now, we do know the flashbang is headed up to Delaware this weekend. Matter of fact, this evening he's headed up. So that would kind of give us a reason why. Now, these are the sub hunters that launched this morning. I just want to show you 13 P8s and one P3 that were up this morning that just all bolted out of Jacksonville, heading to different locations. And so that I thought was really interesting. But let me see here. I'm going to just kind of get in, make sure I'm not missing anything. We had the East Coast refuelers. Okay, and then we did have one West Coast tanker that was running a few routes over kind of east of Santa Barbara early this morning as well. Just part of the other sea of tankers that were up. But look at this. So this one's just hanging out, obviously giving some juice to somebody. There may have been a red flag going on in Vegas. But also keep in mind, we got a lot of ships sitting off the coast of California. And then, of course, we have the heavy lifts. We just looked at what it looks like now, which is actually about 2x what we're looking at here. But this was an hour and a half, 2 hours ago. And you can see that was also a pretty high volume of C-17, C-130s, heavy lifts, okay? All right, let me skinny this down for a minute. And we'll come back to this map here at the end if we have some time to do it. I'm going to try and hold us to half an hour. I do have a lot to cover for being 30 minutes. But you can see these are a lot of these heavy lifts we're already looking at. A lot of the tankers. There's your R-135 Spybirds up running some routes. These are both. Now this one is a little unusual for that location. 34,000 feet. So he wasn't up here doing touch and goes. But he's over North Dakota, and you can see he's just basically hanging out, you know, in the area, a little bit north of Bismarck, west of Grand Forks and Fargo. Looks like he's returning, doing a little RTB, but that is a Spybird. Let me see if we got any others. That's a tanker, actually a refueler up there. That's your other Spybird headed out this direction. I don't know what they do up here. It's just kind of interesting to see. Like I said, I don't really know. And these are going to be your teals. These are weather birds right here, usually hurricane hunters. Okay. Now, let's get over here real fast, just show you what's going on relative to the volcanic activity. Look at the ash spewing from this one right here. Cerro Negro, that's a pretty large ash cloud. So that's bigger than we usually see on any given level, even bigger than La Palma. That, if you're spewing ash across that will give you a lot of health issues, but that will also disrupt air traffic because they got to go around that usually. They don't really fly unless it's in different levels and layers. They may try to zing through, you know, under it or something or over it, but that is a pretty daunting ash cloud. La Palma's still spewing. Nothing else. This whole side over here has been really quiet, which is it's kind of unusual. Normally we see something going on down here, you know, in Java and Indo, even Japan, to see that all quiet. But this section, which makes you kind of wonder, we were covering in the last sit rep the earthquake swarm that was going off the coast of Portland and at a higher level too. These were at like 5.5, 5.8, and a bunch of them. To see that going on there and then seeing this happen down the you know, that coastline right there, that's pretty interesting. You've got seven volcanoes right here from South America all the way up to Central America. That is a large amount. So something in terms of the Ring of Fire is definitely cranking on that side. Okay, let's get over here to Flashbang, see what he's up to for today. He's delivering some closing remarks for a virtual summit on democracy. You can't make this stuff up. Okay. Or, you know, lack of democracy. Let's see here. You should have made it on communism. It probably would have been more fitting. But looks like they are headed out to Wilmington, Delaware, about 5:45 p.m. This afternoon. And, of course, if we were to go over and look at my radar, we're going to go ahead and pull that up real fast just to see what the TFRs are out there. This would confirm that. As you can see, that's going to be his Delaware thing. This is, again, Senior Living Center, Brown Zone. These orange dots or squares, are going to be thunderstorms. Not too much else. We got a little tiny one down here in Florida that is probably tied to natural stuff, if I can get it to pull up. Very small, down by Indiantown. It's hazards. And, interesting. Something about aircraft relief, aircraft ops under Griffin Wrecking Company. So I don't know what that's all about, but I'm sure if you live down there, you probably are aware of it. And not anything down in the islands. These are normal for Texas. That's space operations, border stuff. That's always there. We do have a new one out here off of near Ventura out here. Let me see here. Oxnard. Let me see what this is all about. Security. All right. Which is about as deep down as you can go on that one. All right. That's Beale Air Force Base. That's always there as well. So, but these are the earthquakes we're talking about. Now, these are the latest that are showing, just two, 5.4, 5.2. The other day I clicked on that swarm in our last sit rep and it, the whole right side was just blasted full of earthquake tremors. So, all right, let's see how we're doing over here on Brokeback Better. Let's see, this is gonna be, this is LA port. These are gonna be your ships that are waiting, cargo ships only, waiting to get into port. The ones with the arrows are moving and they're probably just jockeying for position. And then that is our port. Doesn't look to be getting any better, folks. That is a lot of boats waiting to get in. And so every day just looks to be about one and the same. All right, so let's look at Biggs Army Airfield. This, we had an arrival come in. This is gonna be one of your Sierra Pacific birds. 737-500 came out of Tucson. It actually did a round robin and let me see, it went back to, where is this headed to? Jacksonville, North Carolina is the route for that particular one. Now, I did see, oh, that was yesterday, sorry. So it looks like they are taking some poppies out to Jacksonville, North Carolina. So if you live in Jacksonville, congratulations, you have just inherited a bunch of poppies. All right, let me look at departures real fast. I just want to see what we've missed since the last time we were together. This was on Wednesday. This was a SPA 109 that went back and forth to Tucson. That's what I was looking at earlier. This is going to be National Cargo, and it looks like they flew a load. That's a 757-200 out to Burlington, Vermont. And that, so this Biff is kind of like Dick's up in the Northeast in Jersey and that general area where they are basically, that seems to be the hubs for moving most of these folks around. My understanding is that in New Mexico at the campsites, they're sitting around 14,000 to 16,000 Afghanis that are living at those locations right now. So we're gonna be seeing flights for quite some time, I would imagine, moving these people out, okay? But that is gonna be Biggs. And then of course, this beautiful set of news right here, 6,000 Afghan refugees expected in Houston. The total US number is still unclear. This, they're expecting, this news came out on December 9th, and they are actually, saying that they expect them to be in place by just after the first of the year. You give that some thought. 6,000 is bigger than a lot of cities around our country. Most of them are probably, small cities, right? But your average city is probably 15,000 for a decent size city in the U.S. And that's almost half the population of that. That's a lot of people going into one city. Now, Houston, obviously, can absorb some of that, but you're not talking like doctors and surgeons and people that are highly skilled that they're bringing into our country. These are people that aren't really going to contribute a lot for the most part to our society other than probably voting and taking government subsidies and having a lower skill set. So not good, really not good especially if you're trying to raise up the poverty level within a country, right? So, okay, on the brink of more good news. This is going to be actually McGuire. What they do, they're flying these folks into Wrightstown, New Jersey, and then they'll put them on the buses and take them just right across the way there over to Dix, Fort Dix. And so looks like we had an arrival come in from Norfolk, and then we had a departure, actually, Air Transport International that flew over to Baltimore from there. Let's see where it went from there, if anywhere. That was 10 hours ago, so it may not have taken off yet. It's still sitting on the ground. More than likely, that's going to take a load of poppies and bring them somewhere within the country. All right, and then we got scheduled to come in. We have a 747-400 coming in from Chicago O'Hare, rolling into McGuire. All right, now over here to the board, the live board. This is actually going to be all your Swift Air flights. It looks like we've got a regular now rolling in and out of Havana to Miami, El Salvador to Miami. Now, the bigger question is whether or not these are coming out empty. I don't know that they are, but you know, you want to believe that they're taking a load down and actually deporting people. But it doesn't make a lot of sense. That's one of the things I really don't understand about our immigration system or policies right now, because if you're bringing them in abundance, you're flying them into locations in the U.S., and then all of a sudden, next thing you know, you're turning around and you're flying them out of the country. Something is definitely weird with that, because it's just a waste, you know, talking about fraud, waste, and abuse, right? But this one here, rolling out of Yuma to El Paso. Again, Yuma's a location I'm pretty confident that we have a residing or residence there from Afghanistan. And of course, Yuma is a proving ground. So there's technology and systems that go into Yuma that are not public. I will tell you that coming off of black programs, Yuma is used quite a bit to do a lot of research stuff, you know. And so to think that we're putting people that are within eyesight of that type of technology or even at a military base all by itself is just simply astounding to me. All right, that one's coming out of Long Beach, headed over to Tucson. And this last one here looks like it was Alberta, Canada, down to Los Angeles. Now, if you go back and look at what was happening just 2 hours ago of the Swift flights, you can see, you know, there was a lot of southern traffic going on, as always. We do have one going from El Salvador up to Alexandria. Again, Alexandria, Louisiana is a 72-hour holding facility operated by a third party, but they do, Customs Border Patrol and those folks are still actually, there on site. So, okay, that's what was going on this morning with those gents. And let's bump over here so we get on through the board. All right, this is going to be one of the Spobbird 709. Now, we already looked at that one, so I'm going to skip on through since my screen is hanging up on me from FlightAware. All right, on over to Guantanamo Bay. This is kind of a normal flight. What I'm seeing is a 773RB that just entered into the sequence on Tuesday looks to be replacing some of the other normal birds that go in and out. So I think what they've done is just added another aircraft to their quiver, and it looks to be in kind of the normal rotation now. So this is a Tuesday, Friday kind of flight for that tail number. So we'll watch it, because it is, anytime the agency starts using a new bird, it's always good to just keep a list of them so you can track them wherever they go. And when they pop back into the scene, you've already kind of got, you know, on the back of the napkin, you know, what they're up to. So one thing I will add is that we did have this one that came in. I missed it on Thursday of last week. I didn't see it. The little medevac bird, N36LJ. But this is, it's a nice little Learjet. And I didn't catch it. And so it came in from Tampa, which is kind of a normal spot for those to come in. And then from there, it rolled out and went up to Norfolk, Virginia, which is the naval installation. And then from there, it's been all over the place. So, okay. Now, as we continue to look on at our Guantanamo Bay birds, let's just take a quick look. This is the one that came in today at new in the rotation, 626CT. Since then, you know, this thing just kind of bouncing around Boca Raton over to Guantanamo Bay. It's been up to Chicago. Spent some time on the weekend in Opa-locka, right? We know about that place. And then, let's see, we go over here to 773 RB, and we're going to come back to that, let that marinate for a second. 173 PA, this is one of your gray birds, owned and operated by Phoenix Air. Came out of Venezuela up to DC early this morning. So that means we probably had some agency guys down here in that general area. We seem to be doing a lot of work between Venezuela and Colombia, a lot of it. All right, because we do see the spec ops birds going back and forth from there pretty regularly. Okay, 773 RB, it's actually en route right now. This is interesting. It's not going to Guantanamo Bay, which is over here. Looks to be headed down to St. Martin. All right, now you remember Little St. Martin, I believe, is the one where Epstein's Island is. Doesn't have a runway, so if you land on this one, you take a little boat, hop, skip, and a jump across the way, and you are there. Okay, so it's either St. Martin, maybe it's Little St. John's. I don't remember, but he's out in this general area. But this is kind of the biggest, one of the only airports you can really land on this general area to get to these islands. So, but that's where that one's headed, okay? All right. Yeah, the Little Saints, man, they all run together at some point, right? All right, C202. This is going to be rolling out of Seattle, Washington, back to DC yesterday. This is the one that this guy's logging some miles. Let me tell you, he's been down to Guantanamo Bay, Puerto Rico, LAX, San Francisco, Seattle. That is going to be either the assistant director of Homeland Security or Homeland Security director, one of the two, but that's who usually rides on those, is Homeland Security. Okay, over here in 721 AL, this actually landed 3 days ago. I was just watching it. We talked about it on Wednesday, coming out of Brunswick up to DC. I was actually had it on the board because I was waiting to see if they went back down and picked some folks up. It looks like these guys are getting a weekend stay down there, and then they'll probably see them roll back down to pick them up early next week. Okay, and then Guantanamo Bay bird. I slipped this one in at the backside, which was my bad. Again, it's still reloading, so let me just, rather than sit and stare at a white screen, let's talk about this bird, which is going to be in 412DE, that's a Department of Energy helicopter, aka the Sniffer. Just wanted to show you, it looked like it is back now. This is inside the Senior Living Center, Brown Zone area, right? He's just running, looks like a calibration flight, just going back and forth across the airport. Many, many, many legs back and forth. Altitude seemed to be, you know, green line is the altitude. A little bit of spike there. May have been a test hop. Maybe done some maintenance or something and just had to do a couple routes on the airport. All right, let's get back over to 302 AZ. Sorry, I'm hopping around on you. Wanted to point this one out because it landed an hour and 10 minutes ago back in Miami, but it was in Bahamas. All right, and so these are one of the locations we've been kind of watching in terms of international sites, if you know what I'm saying. So that would be, if you're not familiar with them, we call them rendition flights or things of that nature. And so anyway, that this is a spot that we watch for them landing in and out. They go into the Turks and Caicos, Jamaica. They go to a lot of little, very close spots. And the reason for that is, you know, you roll out of Miami, Lauderdale, somewhere in that area. You're airborne, and within just a couple of minutes of being airborne, you're over international airspace. And then at that point, the rules of engagement change. And so they'll take people out here and give them the shakedown. So, okay. Now, we talked about that one. Last one is going to be this spy bird. This is one of those Dash 8 spy birds. We've been watching. It's R50348. We watched this one in the past pretty regularly. But it rolls out of D.C. and it heads out over here off of the Jersey coast or over Jersey. And remember, we have a ton of poppies in that location. And so they are probably, they're not doing the normal spin cycle where you see them grabbing cell tower data, but they are certainly grabbing something when they're out here because this bird has that capability. You'll notice the yellow line is airspeed. So that thing was really fluctuating. Probably in those turns is where you see those airspeeds dip. But altitude-wise, it kind of maintained other than, you know, it was down around 15,000 and then bumped up to about 25,000 feet. All right. Now, one thing I just wanted to point out, because we have not escaped this one yet, and nor will we, this is China's Evergrande. We talked about this in the past. I've talked about it in our Monkey Minute. They just officially defaulted on a dollar debt. Let's see what the amount was. It was not the $300 billion. Looks to be $19.2 billion. And so that's going to start triggering some things. It looks like they're trying to do a controlled descent, but they have more than $300 billion in total liabilities. And this one punches China right in the pocket. So this is going to be pretty wild to watch. It will impact us. It'll impact the rest of the world once somebody just lets it free fall, okay? So there is that one. Now let me back over here to our ADS-B, and I'm hoping that my green screen will go away in a minute. Now my white screen. There we go, we're back. It wasn't too bad, but just kind of point out up here, northeast, again, kind of these surges that we see happening. You've got several Navy P-3s that are out just east of kind of SeaTac. You got a tanker that's up. You've got, let me see what else we have in this general area. Quite a bit of traffic for sure. That's a fighter rolling. Let's see, he's at 24,750, and that is a C-17 that's climbing out down pretty low. So that not related. For a minute there, I thought that was a C-17 with a fighter escort, but doesn't look that way, does it? When you zoom in. And let me see, B-737, looks like he's just doing some touch and goes. That's a Navy whitetail. All right, back up, let's get down here to California, Southern Cal. Got a couple C-130s that are headed north. And air refueler, just getting off the ground. Got one, looks like a air refueler headed out to Hawaii. Then of course we got this, that's a E3 Sentry, AWACS, looks to be headed in to Southern Cal, and then C-17 just taking off. A couple big ones there, you know, H-53, Sea Stallion, and that is running, basically doing a little perv mode right off the beach, up and down the coast north of San Diego. And there is that, okay. All right, let me back up, get over here, a couple fighters here. See what else we got, if anything. It looks like, again, this is all trainer flights here. Really quiet along our border, really quiet. These are all trainers down here as well. Kind of unusually quiet. We do have, looks like we have a Sentry doing some routes. Now, that's kind of that figure eight. Normally, if they go into that full circle spin, they're grabbing tower data. They could still be grabbing tower data, or they're working through a marshalling pattern, maintaining 30,000 feet and doing some air traffic control out in that general area. Don't see a lot of congestion now. If they were working it for these, maybe, but not really anything else out there. So they may be actually looking down and not out. All right. And then here's another Sentry up here, Sentry 60. That is just not an accurate, it's probably a smoother line. It's just his signal line has gotten jacked up. Also headed westbound. All right, Florida looks to still be very busy, as does the Northeast. So that is going to do it for today's sit rep. So if you guys are in the chat, don't forget we're going to bounce over to Q&A for 30 minutes in the other link. And so I'll see you guys over there. Everybody else, we'll see you on Monday unless something crazy happens over the weekend. You guys stay frosty out there. God bless. Monkey out.
Check out the latest gear and products at MonkeyWorksUS.com.